whatever happened to romance? Whatever happened to the first impressions? Kissing lessons, it's all too fast. Magic moments don't last. No, hello, no, can I get to know you? No, everybody's in for the thrill of the minute. Whatever happened to romance?
What the hell are you doing? You promised to stay away.
I couldn't help it.
Yeah, well, if Sean sees us, all this will have been for nothing.
He won't. Relax. A few hours, you'll be Mrs. Wilkes.
Yeah, not for long.
You sure, though? You sure you can go through with it?
Yeah, it was your idea.
No. I know. You're right.
It'll all be worth it. I promise. Now, sling your hook. I have to get ready, and I don't want to ruin the mystery.
Has anyone seen a bag lying around?
Aren't you supposed to be at a wedding?
Yeah, I am supposed to be. Oh, it's such a rush. I haven't even thought about what I'm saying at the ceremony.
Oh, it's lovely that he's asked you.
Well, I should have enough material. We've known each other since we were kids. I just wish I had more time.
You've done amazingly well to plan it all in just a few weeks.
Shotgun, is it?
No, she's not pregnant. They've had a whirlwind romance. I think it's lovely.
So the groom's loaded, is he?
Well, the family business has always been successful. It's not like that.
So what is it that makes her the perfect woman for him, then?
I don't know. I've not met her yet. What?
This is it.
Oh, Ruth, you're a star. Thank you.
Morning. What are you doing here?
Sorry, I've got a rush.
Oh, have fun at the wedding.
Thanks, I'll try. Oh, hello, Mrs. Davies. You're here early. You here to see Dr. Carter?
Yes, I just thought I'd be ready.
Okay. Well, see you later.
And Jimmy too. Where's Heston?
He rang to say he's running late.
Oh, right. Well, it's going to have to be one of you two then. I need someone to come to the homeopathy. But the more we know, the easier it'll be. A PCT initiative that they're launching. Does anybody read my emails?
Look, I am sorry, Julia, but you see, I am far too busy. Jimmy.
Is it really worth our time?
George used to offer it when she worked here.
That was complementary medicine, not the same.
My friend's aunt, she had migraines and she tried everything, but it was homeopathy that finally cured her.
There you go. Thank you, Karen. You see? Well, it isn't going to hurt to give our patients choices.
Choices, yeah. Phony treatments. Nah.
Oh. Well, thanks for your support. Phone's ringing, Karen.
A bit unfair. Julia can't control PCT programs.
Doesn't mean we have to like them. I mean, homeopathy is pointless. It's a waste of time.
Wise words, Dr. Clay. Wise words.
What? That's a bit of a sweeping statement.
It's based on treating symptoms with whatever causing them. It's just guesswork.
You don't like it because you can't explain it. Plenty of things science can't explain.
You know, the trick with public speaking is to imagine yourself naked.
Actually, it's the other way around.
Works for me.
Yeah, it would. Mm. Oh, this is the longest morning ever.
Still time for the groom to escape, then.
Never thought that it could be true love?
No.
What's happened to romance?
There you are. Sorry to burst in like this.
Oh, Sean! Hey! Daniel, this is the groom.
Oh, congratulations.
I think I've made a terrible mistake.
What's the matter?
Well, the hotel rang to say that the room he wants has been double booked. She's going to go mad.
I'm sure that we can sort it out.
Thanks. I can't think straight today. Knew a last-minute stag do was a bad idea.
What sort of best man is Anthony? He should be here helping you.
Well, he said something about having a surprise planned.
Oh, I don't like the sounds of that. I am sticking with you until you're safely married. Come on, I'll give you a lift.
Hang on, there's hours of surgery left.
In the temp? Do you ever listen?
What did you want?
Excuse me. Ta-da.
Yeah, but what? Are we seeing that in a minute?
Yeah, I know that. But I thought maybe you'd like a private showing.
What now? I'm sure. If he catches
us. Oh, come on. We both know what a bad boy you really are. And with me in my wedding dress.
You have no idea. But you'll have to wait. We can't blow it now. Seriously?
If someone doing the dirt, you're not very, are you? You better be worth the wait.
I will be. Promise.
No need to panic. There's a few nice rooms left, so he's going to get the key and we can choose the nicest one.
What would I do without you?
I thought there'd be a few more guests here by now.
Yeah, about that. You know, I said it's a small wedding. I actually meant it's just the four of us.
What about your parents?
Dad, they're on a cruise. Seemed pointless to drag them back.
Pointless seeing their only son get married? Why can't you wait?
No, we just want to get married. We'll tell them as soon as they get back.
So you haven't even told them. Sean, are you sure about this?
If you'd like to phone me.
Of course I'm sure. Look, you'll love Sarah. Come on.
Hi, Sean, it's me. Can you give me a call when you get this message? Look, it's Sarah. Something I need to talk to you about.
Way, let's go. Come on. Michelle?
Yeah, I'm coming, I'm fine.
That's a lovely view.
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah. Oh, wow. Oh. You look amazing.
Why have they put us in here? I thought you booked the Arndale suite.
Yeah, sorry, I am.
Can you smell like a brewery? Are you hungover?
Well, I had a few drinks with Anthony last night.
Oh?
Hi, Sarah, I'm Cherry.
Hi.
Oh,
God, you idiot! Don't worry, we can get it sorted. Come on.
He's still drunk, guys.
There you go.
You'd
never know.
Oh, no. Clumsy.
Yeah, he's always been butterfingers. They wouldn't let him on the school cricket team because he couldn't catch. He never got over that.
Cricket?
Yeah, I'm surprised he managed to tie him down to a summer wedding. He's normally at home watching endless test matches.
I wouldn't know.
No.
Transfer into the bed, please. Ready? On my three. One, two, three. Good. Trolley out. Right, it's getting hooked up.
No cardiac output, he's gone into VF.
Okay, crash trolley. Back in, please. Pads. Charge. Everyone ready? Clear. Charge. Clear.
You're all right, mate. A lot more nervous than me. What's up?
That's what I gotta say.
Sounds serious. Bit of last minute advice.
No. Look, I need to show you this. It's about Sarah.
Oh. Oh, she looks amazing, doesn't she?
Just give me 2 minutes.
Yeah, right. Sorry, mate, this isn't the right time to be showing me your newest app, OK? Time to make an honest woman out of her. All set. Mm-hmm. Where's Cherry?
Oh, still doing her makeup. Some take longer than others.
Why don't you go and get her?
No, no, I'll go. I'll tell the registrar while I'm at it.
That's odd. You're overdue an arthritis prescription.
That must be wrong. I've got plenty.
Well, you shouldn't if you're taking the correct dose. You are taking your pills, Mrs. Davis. You should have come to see me much sooner if you're not happy with the medication.
Well, actually, I'm thinking of homeopathy.
What do you think Cherry said to Sean?
Cherry.
We should have thought of this before. She could talk him out of it and ruin everything.
Look, you can still get out of this. If you go now.
But what about the money?
Forget the money. Was it really worth all this?
Taking yourself off prescribed medication is not a good idea.
But homeopathy sounds marvellous. Dr. Diana is opening a new clinic and she's explained it all to me.
Do go on.
You know how they mix the molecules and that water has memory so it knows how to cure you.
Water does not have a memory and there are no miracle cures.
But Dr. Diana has treated loads of people and she says there's always an improvement.
Placebo effect. There's no scientific evidence at all.
But science has got it wrong before. What about those poor babies that were born with defects because of that morning sickness drug?
Thalidomide is very unusual to have such extreme side effects.
But how do I know my pills are safe? As long as the drug companies are making millions and buttering you up with freebies, they don't care what happens to me.
I don't prescribe for freebies. The point is, your condition is best managed with drugs.
You deny me my right to choose.
No, but you need a treatment that works.
Well, homeopathy works. Why would some people offer it on the NHS otherwise?
NHS Trust jumping on the bandwagon.
You can't make me take your pills. If homeopathy is good enough for Prince Charles, then it's good enough for me.
I mean, with all due respect to the future king, who is not a doctor, this homeopathy nonsense is nothing more than a scientific joke. And anyone who says otherwise is a complete buffoon. The world has gone mad, utterly mad. I can go into recycling.
You've been in this homeopathy stuff? Do you think it's going to go bananas?
What homeopathy stuff?
Ridiculous, isn't it? I told Julia I was simply far too busy to get involved with...
Why wasn't I told about this?
What? Julia did email everybody. The post-it note on the front's a good enough clue.
Are you all right, Heston? You're going a little bit purple.
Dr. Diana is not getting her charlatan claws into my patients.
Who's Dr. Diana?
I don't know, but I don't fancy your chances.
What's going on? I saw you two kiss.
It's not what you think.
Unbelievable. You can't even take your eyes off her before she's about to marry your best friend.
He's your friend too. Where have you been the last few months while this has been going on?
Maybe I can make up for it now.
No, Cherry, not like this, please.
Anthony, I've got to do my reading.
This homeopathy nonsense is nothing more than a scientific joke, and anyone who says otherwise is a complete buffoon.
Do you mind if we have a few minutes?
Okay, why is everyone being so weird?
I think that you should tell him now. If you don't, I will.
Don't you dare. This has nothing to do with you.
I'll say what I like. I'm not going to let my friend marry someone that's cheating on him with his best friend.
Don't be daft, Anthony.
Of course not.
Oh, come on.
You got it all wrong. I can't stand her.
What?
Hey!
Don't talk to her like that.
She's a money-grabbing cow. She's only marrying you for your money. Check your bank statements too. She's spending money all over the place.
But you're not making any sense.
Mate, I'm sorry. She's stitching you up.
With all the traps here and there, I don't suppose I could tempt you into joining up. Well, have a think about it.
Thank you.
Seriously, what are you on about?
She wants your money.
You're unbelievable. I said she could spend what she likes on the wedding.
Come on, wake up. How much do you think a wedding with only four people costs?
Stop it. You can't hide your jealousy by having a go at Sarah.
Jealousy?
Yeah, she chose me and you hate that. Just because you can't hold onto a girlfriend for more than 5 minutes, you don't want to see anyone else happy.
No, it's not like that.
So why have you been pestering me for weeks?
Because you've been planning to take all his money. I needed to be able to prove it. Look!
Maybe we should just all calm
down. Sean, I couldn't stand the idea of you marrying her. I thought if you saw what she was really like, then I wouldn't have to tell you.
Tell me what?
That I'm in love with you.
Longing for the tranquility of general practice. Do you want to talk about today?
Being here makes it all seem so real. I mean, I know you hear about bombs and stuff in the news, but it doesn't sink in. Here, you know straight away they're going to end up on your ward.
I'm sure Corporal Martin will be very pleased that you were there for him today.
Makes treating old ladies bunions and dishing out condoms to students seem so trivial.
And what's triggered all this? A cosy chat with an officer, maybe?
I'm 30 on Saturday.
Oh, it's just a number. It's not as life-changing as everyone makes out.
Yeah. Maybe it should be.
Oh, now I've heard everything.
Are you really gay?
Are you mental?
Do you think that by making up another ridiculous story, you're going to make me change my mind? Do you know what? Get out. I don't want you here.
Are you not serious? After everything I've just told you?
What? That you haven't had an affair with Sarah and that she has spent a few quid on the wedding? It's hardly revelation of the century, is it?
And what about...
Oh, you've been in love with me. Yeah, I think I'd notice that. Now, if you don't mind, we've got a wedding to be getting on with. I guess we need to call the registrar back and get a new witness.
I'll go.
I have no idea what Anthony was really like.
Just forget about Anthony, OK? I can't believe a word he says now. Why would he pretend to be gay?
I've no idea. Totally ridiculous.
All that stuff about money.
I mean, I suppose he was trying to protect you.
Yeah, well, he needn't have bothered. I mean, it's not as if the business is worth anything. Pretty rubbish gold digger you'd make.
What do you mean?
Well, as soon as Dad retires, best thing for me to do is close it down and pay off the debts. Oh, please. No, he wasn't right, was he?
I'm sorry. I just can't... What's going on? You are joking.
At last, I have been trying to speak to you all afternoon about this homeopathy nonsense.
Yeah, what about it?
Dr. Diana may have seduced the PCT, but she is not getting my patients.
Who's Dr. Diana?
Complete charlatan spouting rubbish.
She's a doctor?
Oh, how many doctors use their Christian names? Dr. Heston, Dr. Zara.
Yeah, all right, listen, I have no idea who she is. I'm sure she's got nothing to do with the PCT. Now, look, stop worrying about her and turn your attention to this.
Homeopathy and the NHS, a pilot programme. Have the PCT completely lost their senses?
No, look at it. I mean, I think that could be good for our patients. What have we got to lose? If we're serious about this new practice, then it won't hurt to support the PCT on this.
We have everything to lose. Our reputations, our self-respect. You may wish to pacify the PCT for political purposes, but I am having no part in it.
Where's your wife?
Not married.
What happened?
Let's just say you were right.
Mate, I'm sorry.
That's what you wanted, isn't it?
No, not like this. I have to show you what she was really like.
Yeah, you could have just told me.
Wouldn't you believe me? Like when I told you Sarah Jennings was only sleeping with you to get tickets to that concert. And then she dumped you, took someone else. Or when I told you not to buy that posh necklace for Bernice. Looked lovely on her when she was marrying... what's his name? I had to get evidence.
Yeah, okay. I'm an idiot. I get it.
No, you're not. Just can't see what's staring in the face. Wouldn't have mattered how many times I told you.
Oh, and I suppose the fact that you fancy me has been staring me in the face too.
Hi, Mum. It's me. Yeah, no, I'm fine. Look, what are you doing tomorrow? So you'll be at home all day?
I don't get it. You've had girlfriends, loads of them.
Yeah, nothing that lasted. I've been single for ages now, because I can't stop thinking about you.
You know I'm not
I didn't do this for me. I knew whatever happened today, I'd risk losing you. Looks like I was right. See you, Sean.
Anthony. I'll give you a call about going for a pint sometime.
You're waiting to pick up the pieces.
Bit of a mad day, hey?
Good setup.
Just because things didn't work out how you planned doesn't mean that they won't work out for the best. You needed to tell Sean.
Never told him before, because I didn't want to lose him as a friend. At least that way I could pretend I could still have him.
This is just the beginning for you. There's loads of lovely men out there. One of them will be Mr. Wright.
I don't think I've much chance of finding another Mr. Wright. See you around, Cherry.
Bye.
I was right. Dr. Diana is a fake. Her qualification is from a correspondence course.
Perfectly legal and above board.
If you're happy to have our patients treated by someone trained at a desert commune.
She's got nothing to do with the PCT initiative.
It's a left-wing conspiracy.
Oh, stop exaggerating.
Well, everything about homeopathy is exaggeration. It doesn't work.
Then why have the NHS used it for years?
Why indeed? Wasting millions we could have spent on life-saving cancer drugs.
The costs are comparatively low, actually. And it's not a waste if it helps people who've tried everything else.
You may as well swallow kiddie's sweets for all the good it'll do you.
Plenty of doctors who are members of the Homeopathic Association, all fellow medics, trained to your exacting standards, Heston. They can't all be wrong.
They are.
So the only one that's right is the great Dr. Carter, Well, you know, you can't go around scaring patients and getting your bow tie in a twist because people are still going to make informed choices about their health.
They are not informed!
You are joking, aren't you?
Look, just let me talk to you. I can make you understand.
Have you done it?
Yeah.
Then what on earth do you think we've got to talk about?
Go away.
Stop following me.
I'm not following you. I'm just walking in the same direction.
I don't want to be followed.
We're working to advance the practice and they're working to, well, make headlines turning him into Dr. Sex.